प्रीवियस क्लासेस वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट हेटरोट्रॉफिक न्यूट्रिशन, दैट इज पैरासाइट, इंसेक्टिवरस, सेप्रोट्रॉफ एंड सिम्बायसिस, एंड आई हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट पैरासाइट एंड इंसेक्टिवरस. नाउ वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सेप्रोट्रॉफ्स. सेप्रोट्रॉफ्स आर द प्लांट्स दैट ऑब्टेन द न्यूट्रिशन फ्रॉम डेड एंड डिकेइंग ऑर्गेनिक मैटर. So they, this type of plants, they secret digestive juices on the dead and decaying matter and then absorb the nutrients from it, and the mode of nutrition by which they get the nutrients, that is called saprotrophic nutrition. That is called saprotrophic nutrition, or you can say the plants who get nutrients by saprotrophic nutrition, they are called saprotrophs. So saprotrophs, they get the nutrition from dead and decaying matter. They secrete digestive juices on dead and decaying matter and then absorb the nutrients, and their mode of nutrition is called saprotrophic nutrients. And another thing you can say that saprotrophs are decomposers. Saprotrophs are decomposers because they obtain the energy for their own use by breaking down complex organic matter from dead bodies of other organisms. That means they are decomposers. They decompose the dead bodies of other organisms and they get the energy by breaking the complex organic matter. So at the same time, when they are decomposing the dead bodies of other organisms, they are releasing some vital chemical elements. So that when they decompose the dead bodies, they release some vital chemical elements which is absorbed by the autotrophs. So they are releasing the vital chemical elements to the soil, and it is useful for the autotrophs or absorbed by the autotrophs. So they are adding recycling of materials from dead organism to living ones. So they are called decomposers. So once again I am telling, saprotrophs are called decomposers because they obtain their energy by breaking down complex organic matter from dead bodies of other organisms, and they are helpful for our environment. Why? No, because when they decompose the dead bodies of other organisms, they release some vital chemical elements which is absorbed by the autotrophs and which is good for the autotrophs. So the bacteria or the fungi who all are found in this category, they are known as saprophytes. They are known as saprophytes. So fungal and bacteria saprotrophs, they are called saprophytes. For example, you can take fungi. These all are, fungi is a saprophyte, or it undergoes saprotrophic mode of nutrition. So fungi, under warm and humid conditions, fungi start growing on articles like dirty clothes, leather objects. It can grow very fast. Fungi grow well in wet, mossy and damp weather. Rainy season is good, very good environment for fungi. So rainy season provides suitable environment for fungi to produce spores. So for this reason, fungi appear during rainy season. Mostly during rainy season, fungi appears. It can grow under warm and humid conditions also, on dirty objects, on leather objects, like that articles it can grow, and it can grow well in wet, mossy and damp weather. During rainy season, it gets a suitable environment to grow faster. So fungi grows on shoes, on the shoes in the rainy season. You might have seen in this, on the shoes, the fungi is growing in the rainy season because the shoes provide fungi with dark, moist and warm environment, that is very good or very suitable environment for the growth of the fungi. So you also might have seen that a piece of bread, when you are keeping a piece of bread, means you are moistening with water the bread, you will moisten the water and you will keep the bread in a closed box for few days, you will see some brown patches, whitish green and brown patches on the bread. You might have seen sometimes at your home. That is because of the growth of the fungus, that is found because of the growth of the fungus. So like in the shoes also it can grow. So to prevent the shoes from the fungi, we should keep them dry, and even to prevent the bread also from the fungi, we should not keep for few days, you should not keep the bread for more than 2 or 3 days, then it can be spoiled. So you should consume it within 1 day. day. So there are some fungi such as mushrooms and yeast which are useful, whereas there are many fungi which causes diseases in plants and animals and humans. So some fungi are also used in the production of medicine. So fungi are also different types. Some are like mushrooms and yeast which is useful. Many are causing diseases in plants and animals, and some are used in the production of medicines. So saprotroph, they obtain the nutrition from dead and decaying matter. They secrete the digestive juices onto dead and decaying matter and then absorb them. Their mode of nutrition is called saprotrophic nutrition. They are called decomposers because they decompose the dead bodies of other organisms to get the energy. So when they decompose the dead bodies of other organisms, they release some vital chemical elements to the soil, which is absorbed by the autotrophs, which is absorbed by the autotrophs like fungal and bacteria saprotrophs. They are called saprophyte. For example, you can take fungi which can grow under warm and humid conditions, and it can grow well in wet, marshy and dampy weather. Damp weather also means rainy season also it can grow very well. Rainy season provides a suitable environment for it. And some fungi like mushrooms and yeast, some fungi, they are useful, whereas some fungi causes diseases in plants and animals, and some fungi are also there used in the productions of medicines. So next we will study about the fourth category, that is symbiosis.